Right, as you heard, overnight the Republicans won back. Now, we've heard what happened. Here to discuss what it means for them and us is Professor Brendan O'Connor of the US Study Centre at the University of Sydney. Welcome back to the show.
Good to join you again.
Well, as we heard, I mean, most people were expecting they'd win, but you'd think, you know, it was some unexpected crisis, but it has been expected. But what can we expect now?
Well, it's hard to know how the Republicans will govern. I mean, they'll have to try to do something to say they've achieved something. They've been the party of no, so it has sort of parallels to, I suppose, the Abbott government here. Now they've got the limelight, now they've got the control of the Congress. Most of their big ideas will be vetoed by Obama. So after a period of sort of showing themselves to be very tough on a range of issues, then there'll be a period probably in a year's time when they'll want to compromise, because both sides will want to say we've achieved something before the next election.
That's the irony though, isn't it? They've been the party of no, and now they're going to make President Obama look like the president of no, aren't they?
A little bit. I mean, it depends how far they go. It seems that they'll probably pull back a little bit from trying to repeal healthcare reform in the United States, what they call Obamacare. So I think there's a sense that that's a bit more successful than the Republicans would have thought a year ago.
You're sounding almost, well, not optimistic, but not as pessimistic as some. Now, you say they mightn't repeal it. I heard a couple of them talking about impeaching him, for goodness sake.
Yeah, that's the kind of talk that will lead to them permanently being out of the presidency. I mean, some Republicans will want to win at the presidential level in the next 10 years.
Isn't that the problem for Mitch McConnell, the new Senate president, the leader, and the House leader? The fact is, can they control the more outrageous elements? They haven't been able to so far, and people like Ted Cruz were threatening all kinds of things already.
Yes, there'll be some young Turks who've got in.
The hog lady.
Who'll claim that they, you know, are there to radically reform the American government. But I think the story really of the last 4 years in America is that in 2010, you know, a fairly wacky bunch of Republicans cost the Republicans winning the Senate. They probably should have won it in 2010. So I think there's been a moderating element this time round.
And cost them the presidency, you could argue, in 2012.
At the presidency,
too.
They've got some big problems with demographics.
But what does it mean broader for the rest of the world? I mean, I take the economic side, because that's where we will be, the rest of the world will be affected. They're all about slashing the deficit, which was already being cut under sequestration. But they don't want any defence cuts. They don't want any new taxes. They're obsessed with that. We've seen where austerity led, where this kind of idea happened in Kansas and destroyed the economy. We've seen austerity not work in Europe. Isn't that a slight worry for the rest of the world, that this fledgling economic recovery that they're all too impatient about might be in jeopardy if they get their head?
For sure. I mean, I'm pretty pessimistic in some ways as well about the ability for compromise, the ability for actually the federal government in America to do a lot. But I think there is probably some sense that the economy is not doing too bad in the United States. Growth is improving. The debt is actually coming down. So for the Republicans to come in and say, look, debt is a sort of moral sin and it's the number one issue in America, I don't think it's going to wash as much. So I think there'll be the sense that, OK, we've got to have a new tact, we've got to have a new face. And so I think there will actually be a bit of sort of inward looking on their side, rather than saying, it's not like sort of 94 when Newt Gingrich came to town and said, look, it's a Republican revolution. I think they realise that most of the public really don't like the Republican Party or the Democratic Party.
But you say that about the economy, and rational people like us and the experts in the US say that the debt's coming down and the economy was improving. But if you look at what people, their number one reason they voted Republican was because they claim they're not happy with the economy, even though the man inherited the crisis and has brought them out of it again. So they're not realistic there. The only thing I can think there is maybe the Republicans now will say the economy, they'll own the recovery.
Yeah, it's probably a two-tracked recovery. I mean, one of the big problems with the American economy is that wages have been pretty much stuck at the lower levels and at the middle class levels for a long time. So Obama, you know, the president who was going to spread the wealth around, that was one of the negative things said about him, he used it as a kind of comment, or off-the-cuff comment, hasn't spread the wealth around. I mean, more billionaires are there under Obama than any other president.
Well, according to Rupert Murdoch, that was caused by the Federal Reserve and their QE policy.
Tax taxation as well, a little bit. I mean, taxation on the rich is not particularly good.
The Republicans were the ones. This is the irony. The Republicans wouldn't let him do the tax breaks. I mean,
and voters aren't always rational. I mean, they generally sort of punish the president's party and whatever problems they are. They're going to say, even if a lot of them, I think, have been caused by the Republicans, a lot of voters are going to say, look, Obama's president. I should be bringing home more money. I should be have more in my pocket, less on my credit card debt.
Well, here's my take on how the most positively I can look at it. The government has been in gridlock for years now. It's almost dysfunctional. So really, them getting control, what's going to change? Can't get worse, can it?
Well, it probably can for Obama.
Oh,
you know,
okay.
I mean, if you've got a number of inquiries going on, you know, any minor sort of mistake is going to be looked into as
well,
though.
Well, there'll be no appointments get through, I would have thought.
Appointments will be very, very difficult.
But they were being knocked back anyway. They were having problems.
But they'll have more ability to control who, you know, gets through as judges. They'll be claiming that in Benghazi, Obama has had some terrible cover up there.
But that's my point, isn't it? It's just going to be more of the same. Gridlock?
For a time. For a time.
But
I think there's such a level of disillusionment and such a level of disgust, really, with American politics. I mean, 39% of the eligible voting population probably turned out in America today. So it's not a triumph for either side. Neither side can say, look, politics is healthy in the United States. People like us. That's
well,
what
part of the problem
us.
Is the midterms themselves. People said, why have we got this? You have elections every 2 years. They're just a protest vote against the government in power. It doesn't help the process, does it?
No, I mean, Americans vote at an enormous rate. I mean, some city elections will be next year. Some states will be having governor's elections next year. So there's continuous elections, primaries. So I think there's almost a sort of exhaustion with the fact that voting doesn't really lead to anything. So it's your loyal people, and the Republicans have proved time and again in these midterms that they're better at getting out their base, that the Democratic supporters, Obama's supporters, are more fickle. They're likely to come out to vote for a president, but they're not so likely to vote for a congressperson or a governor.
And finally, the TPP, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, the great big free trade deal that we're negotiating with America now, some think that even though it's an Obama initiative or it's a priority, that the Republicans might actually pass this one. Where does that look, do you think?
Yes, or I mean, this is a bipartisan opportunity. You know, the free trade Republicans, who tend to be more oriented towards that than the Democrats, can come together with Obama and say, look, we have, you know, found peace on this issue.
That could be the one you're talking about in a year.
What the Japanese are going to do.
We don't care about them. Tonight it's the Americans, and I want to end on that positive note. Thank you very much for putting it in perspective and battling the traffic to get here tonight on what's a rather important night on the political scene. So thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Professor Brendan O'Connor from the US Studies Centre.